I come to you today on behalf of a grateful state for Breonna Moffitt's service and ultimate sacrifice. Today is truly a heartbreaking day for this family, for the people of this city, for this state, and for this nation. Along with Speaker John Burns and Mrs. Dale Burns, the First Lady of Georgia, Marty Kemp, and myself, Representative Gilliard, Representative Jackson, today we honor another of our fallen heroes, a daughter, a sister, a loved one, a friend, a woman who chose a career and a life of service, and a beloved Georgian. When someone is taken from us so young in this life, as Breonna was, and in such a painful way, we are all immediately struck with grief. The souls of those who loved her most are made to ache in such a way that words cannot describe. And we are left searching for the meaning behind this agonizing loss. In truth, there is nothing we can say here today that will mend the broken hearts left in the wake of this tragedy. And there is no answer on this side of heaven that will provide the reason for which we seek. But in spite of all the heartbreak around us in this place of worship, despite the unmet searching, I am reminded of two things shared by Sergeant Moffitt's family after learning of her death. Her mother said, "We weren't there, but she knew we loved her." Her parents went on to say that they are a faith-filled family who believe in God wholeheartedly and always have. Miss Moffitt said, "We always raised our kids to believe in God, to put God first, and I would always say to Breonna, make sure you put God first." And she would say, "You don't have to tell me that because I do it every single day." What a beautiful profession of a family's love for each other and of their faith, a faith that gives us some comfort in these moments of grief. Because although we do not know why Breonna was taken from us so young, we do know that she is in a better place where there is no grief, no suffering, nor any sadness at all. Romans chapter 14, verse 8 tells us, "If we live for the Lord. If we die for the Lord." So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Sergeant Breonna Moffitt lived and died for the Lord and for our country. And in giving the last full measure of devotion and service to this nation, she has ensured that her name will live on forever as one of our honored fallen and someone our hearts and memories will not forget. Breonna belongs to the Lord, and that is who she is at this very moment. And we are thankful for that knowledge, and we will carry it with us as we continue to grieve her passing. To the entire Moffitt family, please know that all of Georgia mourns you with you today. And Marty and the girls and I will continue to pray for you all during this difficult time. As you bear the weight of her loss, please know you do not bear it alone. May God bless the Moffitt family. May he bless those who served alongside Breonna, as well as Sergeant William Jerome Rivers and Sergeant Kennedy Sanders. And may he comfort the grieving hearts of all Georgians on this day of sadness with the hope and peace that only God's love can provide. I now give you the Honorable Chester Ellis.